Hello everyone. In the last lecture we studied about some series circuits, and in this lecture we will continue with parallel circuits. So let us start with parallel RL circuit. First of all, we will draw the circuit diagram. So we have a source here, single phase AC source with voltage V, and resistance and an inductor, both are in parallel. So this is our parallel RL circuit. So we can see that voltage across the source as well as voltage across the resistance and inductor will be common. So in this circuit, voltage is common for all the elements, whereas the current will be individual. So if the current in this resistance is IR and current in inductor is IL, then total circuit current I will be equal to the sum of IR and IL. So here we can take voltage as our reference phasor. Previously in series circuits we took current as our reference phasor because current was common for all the elements, and in this circuit voltage is common for all the circuits, all the elements, therefore we will take voltage as our reference phasor. So if V is given as Vm sin omega t, then reference phasor V can be written as its magnitude and phase angle 0. So this is the voltage phasor, which can be further written in rectangular form like this: V plus J 0, means containing only the real part. So using this we can find out the rest of the quantities, and for that we will write in phasor form phasor I, that is total circuit current, will be equal to the sum of phasor IR and phasor IL. So this is the parallel circuit condition, means total current I should be equal to the sum of IR and IL, means individual currents. So in place of IR we can write V, means total voltage across the resistance, divided by impedance of this part of the circuit. So we already know that impedance of this part of the circuit will be, because this part is purely resistive, so impedance will be R plus J0, means there will not be any imaginary part, whereas impedance of this part of the circuit will be 0 plus J omega L, means there will be only imaginary part, means containing inductive reactance. So we can write this IR as voltage divided by impedance. So here impedance will be R plus J 0, and for second current, means for IL, it will be equal to V divided by 0 plus J omega L, and we know that omega L is actually XL, which is called inductive reactance. So further we can write here V will be equal to, phasor V will be equal to its magnitude V, means only real part. So we can take V common, and inside the bracket we will get 1 upon R plus if we multiply by J in numerator as well as in denominator, then we will get minus J 1 upon omega L. So the current phasor will become this. So using this we can find out the impedance of the circuit. Impedance of the circuit will be equal to Z, which will be equal to V divided by I. So we know that V and I, so it will become one upon R minus J one upon omega L. So this is the impedance of the circuit. So now if we take the reciprocal of this impedance Z, then we will get admittance, means 1 by Z will be equal to Y. So this Y will be equal to 1 upon R minus J 1 upon omega L. So this is admittance. So this Y is equal to 1 by R minus J 1 upon omega L is actually the admittance of the circuit, which is equal to reciprocal of the impedance. So here this first term means reciprocal of resistance is called G, is denoted by G, and is called conductance of the circuit, and plus J B. B is called susceptance of the circuit, and this B is the reciprocal of reactance. So this is Y, where G is 1 by R, which is called conductance of the circuit, and B is equal to 1 minus 1 upon omega L, or we can write minus 1 upon XL. So this is susceptance of the circuit. G is the conductance and B is the susceptance of the circuit. G is the reciprocal of resistance while B is the reciprocal of reactance. So here we can write I will be equal to the product of V, phasor V and phasor Y. Means I is equal to the product of voltage and admittance in case of a parallel circuit. Now we can find out the phase angle of this current I. So phase angle phi of this current I will be equal to tan inverse imaginary part, means minus 1 upon omega L, minus 1 upon omega L divided by real part, means 1 by R. So this will be equal to tan inverse minus R upon omega L. So this is the phase angle phi. So using this we can draw the phasor diagram as well as waveform of the circuit. So first of all, if we draw the waveform, or we can simply draw the phasor diagram. So our reference phasor is actually the voltage phasor here. So first of all, we will draw the voltage phasor, and current phasor will lag by an angle phi, which is equal to the, this phi is equal to tan inverse minus R upon omega L. So we can draw the current, which is lagging voltage by an angle phi. So this is the phasor diagram of the parallel RL circuit. Now, admittance Y is given as G plus J B. Here, G is equal to 1 by R and B is equal to minus 1 upon omega L. So it will become minus J 1 upon omega L. Now we can draw these real and imaginary parts of this admittance along real and imaginary axis. So if we draw the real part, means 1 by R along real axis, then this is G, which is equal to 1 by R, and imaginary part means B, JB, which is equal to minus J 1 upon omega L, will be along this direction. So this will be our Y, which is equal to G plus J B. Now this triangle with this angle phi is called admittance triangle. So as we studied impedance triangle, similarly admittance triangle is also a form of phasor diagram for admittance and its components. So next we will study parallel RC circuit. So once again we will draw the first circuit diagram first. So this is our voltage source V and resistance in parallel with capacitor. Resistance is R and capacitance is C. So this is our parallel RC circuit. Once again the currents will be individual, IR and IC, and this is the total circuit current I, which will be equal to the sum of IR and IC. Once again the V voltage is common for all the elements, therefore we will take V as our reference phasor, and then we will find out I in phasor form. So V, time expression for V can be written as Vm sine omega t. Being a reference phasor, phase angle difference will be zero. So in phasor, we can write it as its magnitude and phase angle as 0 degree. In rectangular form, we can write it as V plus J 0. So now in phasor form, we can write that I, phasor I, will be equal to the sum of phasor IR and IC. IR and IC. Now once again, to find out IR and IC, we need to divide the voltage by their respective impedances. So impedance of this part of the circuit is R, means only resistance, while the impedance of this part of the circuit will be its capacitive reactance, means minus J 1 upon omega C. So we can put those values. So we will get V as common, and in brackets we will get 1 upon R minus plus 1 upon minus J 1 upon omega C. Now we can multiply both numerator and denominator by J. So we will get V within brackets 1 by R. So it will become plus J and omega C. So this is current I. And phase angle of this current will be equal to phi, which will be equal to tan inverse imaginary part, means omega c divided by real part, which will be 1 by r. So it will become tan inverse r omega c. This is the phase angle of the current phase. So using this, we can draw the phasor diagram. So we have a reference phasor as our voltage phasor. So we can draw the voltage phasor along this direction, and then this current actually leads voltage by an angle phi. So we can draw I along this direction, and this angle is phi, which is equal to tan inverse r omega c. So this is the phasor diagram for parallel RC circuit. Now we can write the admittance of the circuit. So this admittance is this, means V into admittance. I will be product of V and admittance. So from here we can write Y as 1 by R plus J omega C. So this is G plus J B, where conductance G is equal to 1 by R, and this B is equal to omega C, means susceptance. So using this, we can draw the admittance triangle. So we will draw G, which is equal to 1 by R along this direction, and then we will draw B, which is JB, which is equal to J into omega C along this direction. So this will be our admittance Y at an angle phi, which is equal to G plus J B. This is the admittance triangle of the parallel RC circuit. So similarly, we can study parallel RLC circuit. We can draw the phasor circuit diagram. We have voltage source V and three elements R, L and C in parallel, connected in parallel. So this is the circuit diagram, C, L and R. Once again, the currents will be individual IR, IL and IC, and sum of these currents will be equal to the total circuit current I. So voltage being common for all the elements, we will take voltage as our reference phasor. So if V is equal to Vm sine omega t, then voltage phasor V will be equal to its magnitude and phase angle as 0, which can be written in rectangular form as V plus J 0. So in phasor form, we can write I, total circuit current I, as sum of IR, IL and IC. Now to find out these currents, we will divide the voltage by respective impedances of these parts of the circuits, of each branch of the circuit. So it will be 1 by R plus one upon j omega l plus one upon minus j one upon omega c. So it will become v, and within brackets we have 1 by r. If we multiply numerator and denominator in both of these terms by j, then we will get minus j 1 upon omega l, and here we will get plus j omega c. So finally we will get v and 1 upon r plus j omega c minus 1 upon omega l. So this is our current phasor I. We can find out its magnitude as well as phase angle. So phase angle for this current phasor will be equal to phi, which will be equal to tan inverse imaginary part, which is equal to omega c minus 1 upon omega l. So it will become tan inverse omega c minus 1 upon omega l divided by 1 upon r. So this is the phase angle for the current phasor. So using this we can draw the phasor diagram. So phasor diagram will be drawn based on the assumption that whether omega c or 1 upon omega l is greater. So if omega c is greater, then this part will dominate, means capacitive reactance will dominate, and in case 1 upon omega l is greater, then inductive part will dominate. So we can draw the phasor diagram. First of all, we will draw the reference phasor V, and then we will draw this minus j 1 upon omega l along this direction. So if this is minus j 1 upon omega l and this is j omega c, and if this 1 upon omega l is greater than omega c, then the resultant will be along this direction. So we will get current along this direction, means current will lag voltage by an angle phi. So this will become our phasor diagram. For parallel RLC circuit, now admittance for this circuit can also be written. Admittance will be equal to 1 upon R plus j omega c minus 1 upon omega l. So admittance is g plus j b, where this g is equal to 1 by R, plus j b is equal to omega c minus 1 upon omega l. So using this we can draw the impedance triangle. So first of all we will draw this 1 by r, which is g, means conductance, which is equal to 1 by r. Then we will draw j omega c this is j omega c, and we will also draw minus j 1 upon omega l, minus j 1 upon omega l. So if this is greater, then resultant will be along this direction, means this will be our y at an angle phi. So y will be equal to g plus j b. This is the admittance triangle of this parallel RLC circuit. That's all for this lecture, and in the next lecture we will study power in single phase AC circuits.